I will tell you about the phase and phase difference in SHM. There are the physical quantities like displacement, velocity, acceleration, restraining force, which are connected with the SHM. So we have to find that whether they are in phase or they have some phase difference. So first I will tell you that what is the phase. As you know, that phase means the physical quantity which describes the motion and direction of vibration or oscillation is called the phase. So let us have the phase and the phase difference. Phase. The physical quantity which describes the position and direction of oscillation or vibration is called phase. So this is what the meaning of phase. The displacement equation in SHM, this y is equal to a sine omega t plus theta. This is the general equation. A is the amplitude, and as we know that all these equations are either the function of sine or cosine. So now let's we have where this A is equal to amplitude. So now from this sign we are having this omega t plus theta. This is called the phase. Phase phi is equal to omega t plus theta. And you are looking that here the term time is coming here. So this is the time dependent phase difference. It is time dependent phase. So this equation is called the instantaneous displacement of the particle from the mean position. So this we take now number one. Similarly, the velocity equation in SHM. This B is equal to dy upon dt, or we have this B is equal to d upon dt into. Now what we have? This is now your A sine omega t plus theta. Now in some of the books, in place of theta, the phi is written. So we are not too confused about it. We can write this theta or this as the phi. Theta is the initial angle at time t equal to 0 that the particle is situated. So this theta is the measure, this whole of this sine omega t plus theta, this is the measure of angle. So this omega t plus theta, this is called the angle, and this angle is called the phase phi. So this V is equal to A omega cos omega t plus theta, and we can write it as A omega sine omega t plus theta plus pi by. We know that trigonometry. Now this can be written, cos can be written as like this. So this is equal to B. So here the phase is how much? Phase, let this is now phi 2, we write down to this one, this is now phi 1. This is now phi 2 is equal to omega t plus theta plus pi. Now the acceleration. Acceleration equation in SS. Now this alpha is equal to dv upon dt as our definition. So this is equal to d upon dt, and this is now your A omega cos omega t plus theta. This is also omega t plus theta. So this is equal to minus A omega square sine omega t plus theta. Because the sine that will be have to so much, and this we can write A omega square sine omega t plus theta plus pi. This is equal to F. So here the phase will be how much? Phase. Suppose this is now your phi 3. This I am giving the name phi 1, phi 2, phi 3. This is the equation first, second, third, like that. So we are having to this one. This is now second. This is now third. So this is now omega t plus theta plus phi. This is now phase of this acceleration alpha. Now the restoring force. Restoring force. That we know this F equal to minus KY. So this is equal to minus KY is equal to A sine omega t plus theta. So this we can write KA sine omega t plus theta plus pi. So this is like this, so this we can write. This is now equation number 4. So now we can have the phase phi 4. This is equal to omega t plus theta plus pi. I have told you the phase of this displacement, velocity, acceleration, and then the restoring force. Now you can find the phase difference. from all these equations that we can have all these in as a graphical term also. In graphs they can be represented like this. Here, this we take the time, this is not zero, this is not suppose zero by on this side, that this is like this. Similarly here, this is not time t, this is not zero, here we take the velocity, then you can have that. And this is now your t by 2, this is now your t, here this is now t by 4, and this is 3t by 4. So now here this we are having to this one, this now so much, this is now having this term to be now so much, this term is so much, this term is so much, that we are having these values. Now for the cosine we can have this way. Pi by 2, this is not 0. This is not like this. Similarly, you can have the this I take the time t, this is I take the acceleration alpha. So now acceleration alpha you can have this values. This is now to be so much, this is now so much, this value is so much. So now what we are having? That in alpha this is like this. This is so much more. This piece. This is for alpha. So this we are having from the negative direction because this alpha is negative as you are looking from here. Similarly for force. So now these terms as you see that this is now your t by 2 and this is now your t. This is now t by 2. This is now term t. Similarly for velocity, the force, this we suppose take the force, then force will also be in the opposite direction, and this is now your, this so much, this is now t by 2, and this is now so much, this is now your t, so this will be like this. So now you can have the comparison of all these and you can directly can tell about the phase difference between all these four quantities and similarly that I have this the phase then you can find the phase difference. So phase difference. Between displacement and velocity. This delta phi is equal to this is your phi 2 minus phi 1. Phi 2 is how much? Omega t plus theta plus pi by 2
minus this is omega t plus theta. So now what we are having is pi by 2 radian. This is not so much. This is what the phase difference. Delta. So phase difference between the displacement and velocity is pi by 2 radian. This is also clear from here that this is now term t by 4. So this is now 90 degree. This is now pi. This is now 3 pi by 4. This is now 2 pi. So the phase difference between these two is equal to pi by 2 radian or 90 degree or delta phi equal to 90 degree. Now the phase difference between displacement and acceleration now this delta phi is equal to phi 3 minus phi 1 phi 3 that of this acceleration so now we have this omega t plus theta plus pi minus omega t plus theta. So now that will be equal to pi. So delta phi is equal to pi, or you can say that this delta phi is equal to 180 degrees. So this is the phase difference between the displacement and the acceleration. Now displacement and the restoring force. Phase difference between displacement and restoring force delta phi is equal to phi 4 minus phi 1. Phi 4 this is equal to omega t plus theta plus pi minus omega t plus theta. So this will be your pi. This is equal to delta phi or delta phi is equal to 180 degree. So phase difference between the displacement and the restoring force is pi radian or 180 degree. Now the phase difference between velocity and acceleration this delta phi velocity and acceleration so this is now your phi 3 minus phi 2 so phi 3 this is omega t plus theta plus pi minus omega t plus theta plus pi by 2. Now the difference will be pi by 2. So this is equal to pi by 2. This is what the phase difference. Or delta phi is equal to 90. So the phase difference between the velocity and acceleration is pi by 2 radian or 90 degree. Now the phase difference between velocity and the restoring force. velocity and restoring force. So this delta phi is equal to, this is now your phi 4 minus phi 2. Phi 4, this is now omega t plus theta plus phi minus, this is now omega t plus theta plus pi by 2. So this is again equal to pi by 2 radian. This is not so much delta phi. Or delta phi is equal to 90.
So the phase difference between the velocity and the restoring force is equal to pi by 2 radian. And this can also be seen from the diagram. And now phase difference
between acceleration and restoring force this delta phi is equal to omega t plus theta plus pi minus omega t plus theta plus pi. So this is equal to how much? 0. Delta phi equal to 0. Or delta phi equal to 0 degree. Simply 0 degree.
So 0 radian or the 0 degree, that is the same thing. It means that the acceleration and restoring force are in the same phase.
Acceleration and restoring force are in same phase. Same phase.
So this shows you that what will be the phase difference between the physical quantities which are associated with the simple harmonic motion. So I have taken them in a single video. You have not to go for different videos for to look the phase difference between displacement, velocity, because so many writers like this in the different videos. In one video they are having this, the phase difference between displacement and velocity, and then displacement and the acceleration, displacement, restoring force, and then velocity and acceleration, velocity and restoring force, and then acceleration and the restoring force. I have taken the single video, so this is very helpful to you to understand that what is the phase difference between the physical quantities that are associated with the simple harmonic motion of a particle. So thank you very much.